Mother's Day is coming up this weekend, which means it's the perfect time to talk about brains. Nom, 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 nom. Everybody probably knows that childbirth is a pretty grisly business. And when new moms go into the delivery room, they're about to lose 10 pounds. And they're also about to discharge things like uterine tissue and blood, incision fluids, urine, breast milk. Ah, the joys of new motherhood. It's triplets. They look just like me. But all that temporary icky stuff aside, some pretty remarkable changes have been going on in that maternal brain because, folks, moms have different brains than we do, which is why they're so good at loving us. Now, studies have shown that new moms undergo pretty significant structural changes in three brain areas. First off, we have the prefrontal cortex, which is right about here. And next up, we've got to open up ye old brain to get to the hypothalamus, which is a little deeper inside than the prefrontal cortex. And finally, we have a change in the amygdala, which if we were to jimmy up inside this brain, it would be more towards the stem. And since those three brain regions deal a lot with our motivation, reward, and emotional regulation, scientists think that the end effect of those brain changes that new moms undergo is the neurological foundation for maternal instinct. You know, the thing that keeps your mom liking you and loving you and doing nice things for you, even when you're acting like a total brat. Not that I can relate, because I was always a perfect angel. In addition to those neurological changes that begin during pregnancy, in childbirth, two hormones called prolactin and oxytocin flood the brain. This is what happens to a new mom's brain during childbirth. Prolactin and oxytocin! And those chemicals foster feelings of bonding and love, yet again reinforcing that maternal instinct to prepare these new moms for the next 18 years of their lives when they have to take care of the thing that is about to be placed in their arms. I love being a mom. So it's pretty fascinating to see how this newer science is uncovering what makes moms mom. Because while we might associate moms with things that they do like cooking dinner or making delicious cookies or picking us up from soccer practice, generally encouraging us and being the most wonderful women in our lives, it's really neat to think about how there were changes in their brains that kicked off when they got pregnant with us that prepared them to be so awesome. And that's a pretty cool thing to think about in terms of the nature of motherhood. So this Mother's Day, let's not only celebrate those amazing women in our lives, but also the super cool science that helped make them that way. So happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there and their super nifty mom brains.